Dear friends, I am Dr. Yusuf Chunawala. I have done my master's in pediatric dentistry and I have been working in the field of bad breath management for almost 20 years, and I have the privilege of starting one of the first fresh breath clinics of India. Now friends, before we actually get into the treatment of halitosis, we need to know the type of halitosis that you are suffering from. So there are various varieties of bad breaths which are available. So the first type is the pathologic bad breath. Now pathologic bad breath is there, then you have something called as the transitory bad breath, then you have something called as physiologic bad breath, and finally you have something called as halitophobia. Now what exactly is pathologic bad breath? Now whenever we are talking about pathologic bad breath, understand that there is a pathology. There is a simple pathology which is there. So the pathology can either be directly dental or medical. Now in dental, you can have dental caries, multiple cavities, then you might have gum or periodontal diseases, then you can have oral cancers, you can have dry mouth, and a variety of disorders will be there. So the treatment here, we will be focusing more on the dental aspects. Then you have the medical. In the pathologic only, you have the medical causes. Now medical causes mean the bad breath or halitosis which is there can be due to the pathology itself, or it can be because of the medications that you can take. Now a simple example, if you're suffering from cough and cold, you will definitely be having halitosis, not only because of the condition that you have, but also because of the medications you take. Most of the cough and cold medications that you take are, you know, will cause dryness of mouth, and believe me friends, dryness of mouth is one of the major causes of bad breath. Now in the other medical causes, if you are suffering from diabetes, you'll have a typical ketone odor. Then if you have hypertension, cardiac diseases, kidney ailments also, in these situations, the medications that you take would cause dryness of mouth, and definite bad breath will be there. So in these situations, we cannot stop the medications. Okay, that okay, since you are having bad breath, let's stop this medication. That's not possible. So in these situations, we have to manage it. We have to employ such methods and mouthwashes and a variety of things which will help you to reduce the quantum of the bad breath. Now, in the other aspects, there is something called as transitory bad breath. Now, what happens exactly in transitory bad breath? Transitory bad breath is primarily because of the foods that you consume. So if you have whatever food, so and the transitory bad breath remains in the mouth over a period of 24 to 72 hours. So like it can be foods which are rich in volatile sulfur compounds, say for example onions, garlic, cabbage, then cauliflower, broccoli, all these are very rich in sulfur compounds, and then there are eggs, fish, milk products. So all these things, the bad breath which is caused because of them is transitory, and it goes over a period of time. Once the food product is cleared from the oral cavity, the bad breath will definitely stop. Then there is something called as physiologic bad breath. Now each one of us has a tongue, okay? So any food that stays back on the tongue, because tongue is a nice grassy surface, and anything and everything stays back on the tongue, even the liquids stay back on the tongue. So whatever stays back on the tongue, little bit of halitosis will be there depending on the quantum of material that remains on the tongue. So now these are the different types of tongues. So whenever you have a look at your tongue, especially after you have consumed your morning tea, if you have had your glass of milk, your tongue will be covered with a white coating, and whenever there is such a coating on the tongue, be assured that you will be suffering from halitosis. Then there is something called as halitophobia also. Now this, many people suffer, especially those who are suffering from bad breath for a chronic period of time. So these phobias also have to be tackled very, very carefully, because it is set in the mind. So it takes a lot of counseling and a lot of treatment modalities for people to get over this. And finally, what I would like to again stress, that everyone has a tongue, and the tongue occupies a major part in the oral cavity. So believe me, each and every one of us has halitosis, only the quantum will vary. Okay, now friends, in my next lecture we will be talking about various myths connected with the halitosis or bad breath. Please do subscribe for my channel. Please do view it, like it, and share it amongst your friends and relatives. Thank you so much.